Hello. Today we are going to discuss yung isang topic na I think everybody can relate, and this is on human intelligence. Bago natin pag-usapan ng intelligence, let's first start with an opening story. Isang araw, si Donna, isa siyang computer programmer who worked in office with two other programmers, si Tom tsaka si Phil. Now, one day, she asked Tom to help her implement some new software applications. Humingi siya ng tulong kay Tom. When Tom sat down with Donna, so tinulungan niya si Donna, to show her how to make changes to the files, nabanggit ni Donna bigla, "I'm so glad you're teaching me instead of Phil. Buti na lang ikaw yung nagturo at hindi si Phil." Siyempre, nung narinig to na Tom, nagulat siya. And he asked, "Why?" Eh, mas magaling naman si Phil kaysa sa kanya. Phil was more experienced than he was. Anong sinagot ni Donna? "Yes," Donna said, "but I feel much more comfortable with you because I get nervous around really smart people." Of course, makukonsider ba nating joke yan? I don't know if it's a joke, but if you are Tom na kinakausap ni Donna dito, more or less, you are going to feel bad. Diba? Mafe-feel bad ka kasi parang ang sinabi ni Donna na hindi ka smart and yung kasama mo smarter than you. Now, the thing is, why is it that it matters to us na tayo ay smart? Diba? We feel good when people see us as smart, and we feel bad if people say that we are not smart. What's the point? Ano ang meron sa pagiging intelligent that it matters to us? The answer, because we consider intelligence as an asset. Isa itong magandang bagay na meron tayo, isa itong psychological resource natin that we consider to be very positive and very important. That's why we like being called smart, because we know that intelligence is important. Diba, totoo naman yan na babad trip tayo if people say, whether directly or indirectly, that we are not smart. Kasi parang ang dating yan, wala pala tayong asset when it comes to intelligence. So intelligence is a very important asset for us because it can improve big time our existence here on Earth. Sabi nga ng isang author, no, beauty may be dangerous, but intelligence is lethal. Ang ibig sabihin lang yan, between beauty and intelligence, it seems like intelligence has higher value compared to beauty. Mas marami kang pakinabang sa intelligence kumpara sa ganda. That's why again, I keep on telling you that intelligence is an asset that I think all people should work for to have. Now, since nag-uusap na rin lang tayo ng tungkol sa intelligence, I want you to reflect tungkol sa sarili mo. How intelligent are you? In a scale of 0 to 10, 10 being the highest, 0 lowest, nasaan ka from 0 to 10? How intelligent are you? How is your brain power doing? But, you know, after you answer that question, kung nakapili ka na, nasaan ka from 0 to 10, now you ask yourself, do you really understand what it means to be intelligent? Diba? Ano yung naging basis mo for you to say that you are a number 7 or you are a number 3 when it comes to intelligence? Ano ba yung essence ng pagiging matalino? That's a very good question to ask. And in fact, this is one of the issues na talagang pinag-uusapan in cognitive psychology. What exactly do you mean by intelligence? In fact, Google can help us do this. Pumunta ka sa Google, tapos i-type mo yung word na intelligence, and then you search for images na related sa intelligence, the following pictures will appear. So more or less, these pictures will give you an idea kung ano ang ibig sabihin ng pagiging matalino, di ba? Yung mga pictures na yan, meron diyang clue, no? Kung ano ang ibig sabihin kapag sinabi mo that someone is intelligent. Another way to do this other than Google is we go back to history at tignan natin yung mga tao who are undeniably smart. Talagang walang kokontra that these people are intelligent. Who are these people? And then we ask ourselves, what do they have in common? Ano ba yung mga bagay na nagagawa nila that we consider them intelligent? When we talk about Albert Einstein, Sherlock Holmes, Bill Gates, Jose Rizal, si Dexter, si late Senator Miriam Defensor, walang duda, all these people intelligent. All these people are smart. But what do they have in common that makes us say that these are smart people. Okay? So, pag-usapan na natin yung definition ng intelligence in the field of cognitive psychology. According to New and Brass 2011, intelligence is the capacity to learn from experience, using metacognitive processes to enhance learning, and the ability to adapt to the surrounding environment. Medyo technical pakinggan yung definition ng intelligence na yan, but if I am going to paraphrase this to make it simpler, intelligence simply means your ability to solve problems and answer questions. Maghanap ng solusyon sa problema at sumagot ng tanong. As long as you can do this, you are considered intelligent. Ikaw ngayon na nakikinig sa akin, I'm sure 100% you are intelligent. You fit this definition. If I ask you, halimbawa, anong araw ngayon? Sagutin mo. Anong araw kahapon? Ano ang araw bukas? Anong oras na? If you can answer all those questions, then that means there is intelligence within you. Yan yung pinagkaiba natin sa mga objects, sa mga animals. Meron tayong kakayanan to solve problems and answer questions. Diba? That's what makes us different from other living beings, plants, animals, or even objects. Wala silang kakayanan to solve problems and answer questions the way humans do. So that's what you mean by intelligence, your ability to solve problems and answer questions. Pero, although lahat ng tao masasabi nating matalino kasi nakakasagot sila ng mga tanong at nakakasolve ng problema, we differ in the levels of intelligence. Again, lahat tayo matalino at some point. But how intelligent we are, dyan tayo magkakaiba-iba. And your level of intelligence depends on anong klaseng tanong ang nasasagot mo. Diba? Lahat tayo matalino, pero iba-iba tayo ng levels. May iba sobrang talino, may iba katamtaman lang, may iba medyo na short ng katalinuhan. What determines our level of intelligence? Anong klaseng tanong ang kaya mong sagutin? For example, most people can answer this question. 3 times 3 times 6. So 3 times 3 is 9, times 6 is 54. If you can answer this equation, anong tawag sa'yo? Matalino ka. Pero ang isang taong nakakasagot ng ganitong tanong, trigonometry question, mas matalino sa tao na ang kaya lang sagutin is a multiplication question. Are they both intelligent? Yes, they are. Pero sino ang mas matalino? Definitely the person who can solve a trigonometry problem. So that's how we mean when we say we differ in the level of our intelligence. Lahat tayo matalino, iba-iba lang tayo ng levels. Now, let's dig deeper in talking about intelligence. Pag-uusapan natin from this section onwards yung three basic truths about human intelligence. At sa tingin ko, lahat ng nag-aaral ng cognitive psychology should master these three truths on human intelligence. Let's start with truth number one. Intelligence is both nature and nurture. Ibig sabihin ng both pareho. Parehong nature and nurture yan. Ang talino ba ay namamana or nanunurture ng environment? Is someone born intelligent or made intelligent? The answer of cognitive psychology is pareho. Merong contribution yung nature, merong contribution yung nurture sa intelligence ng tao. Let's first talk about the contribution of nature sa talino ng tao. No? Ito yung tinatawag nating genetic influence of intelligence. Let me start with a case ng isang tao na namana niya yung kanyang katalinuhan. 27-year-old Jenny is a girl who is considered by many as beauty and brains. Aside from pretty, being pretty, isa siyang Miss Philippines nominee, she is also a PhD holder in psychology. She is also an exceptional teacher in a respected university and is currently doing well in her medical studies in psychiatry. Her father is also a PhD holder in economics and her mom is a well-respected lawyer with a doctorate degree in international law. So, yung parents niya, parehong matalino rin. Her relatives in her father's side are in the field of medicine, while her relatives in her mother's side are in the field of law. So I'm sure in your life, meron din kayo mga kakilalang tao na parang si Jenny, di ba? Kumbaga parang sa Tagalog, pamilya sila ng matatalino. lahat ng kinanununuan nila, nununuan nila, okay, nabubulol ako, ay matatalino. Kumbaga, parang nasa dugo na nila yung pagiging matalino. And this is a scientific basis, no? Na ang intelligence pala, you can genetically inherit that from your ancestors or from your parents. In fact, they have an estimate to this. Sinasabi nila na ang heritability estimate ng intelligence is at around 50%, which means the 50% of your intelligence can be attributed to what you genetically inherited from your parents. Another support na nagpapatunay that intelligence is highly genetic or highly biological is that the way the brain works between intelligent people and not intelligent people, sobrang magkaiba. If you are going to analyze how the brain works in the MRI, the brains of smart people, ikumpara mo yan sa mga brains ng mga average or mga brains na hindi ganun katatalino, talagang ibang-iba yung brain activities ng mga taong matatalino, which again adds to the idea that indeed intelligence is tied to biology or genetics. Kaya merong mga tao, especially girls, no, isa sa mga mahalagang katangian that they are looking for a partner is intelligence. You ask them why, because they'll tell you they want their baby to be smart. Along the way, yung ganyang line of thinking, meron naman talaga siyang scientific basis, no? Looking for a partner who is smart and expecting your baby to be smart, you are using the concept of genetic heritability of intelligence. Pero hindi lang puro nature ang intelligence, kasi meron ding environmental influence sa intelligence. Ito na yung nurture part. Okay? So again, just like what we did in genetics, let's talk about a sample case na nagpapakita ng environmental influence on intelligence. 15-year-old Marcelo was his school's valedictorian. His life was not fortunate. His family's income is way below the poverty level. His mother has intellectual deficiency and his father is dyslexic, causing them not to finish their formal schooling and so find a decent job. Marcelo is really motivated to study to help his family escape poverty. So during his spare time, he would surround himself with books, watch educational videos in the internet shop, talk to his teachers, and spend countless hours studying in their barangay's public library. So masipag na bata itong si Marcelo. His hard work finally paid off as he was given a scholarship by his school because of his exceptional intellectual skills. Later on, he entered and passed with honors medical school and became a well-respected heart surgeon in the United States. So in this sample case, mahalaga yung mga words in red. Surrounded himself with books, watched educational videos in the internet shop, talked to his teachers, spent countless hours studying in barangay's public library. All these are the influence of the environment on a person's intelligence. Alam nyo, tandaan nyo to, smart environment can make you smart. Kapag ikaw ay nakatira sa isang environment that continuously stimulate you intellectually, makakatulong yan sa pagkatalino mo. Imaginin mo na lang doon sa picture if this is your room. Imagine wala kang distraction, wala kang TV, wala kang internet, ang meron ka lang libro. There is no other way to entertain yourself but to read these books. I'm sure, ikulong mo yung sarili mo dyan for 1 year. Paglabas mo ng kwarto na yan, you will become smarter compared to other people who are not in this environment. Ganyan ka-powerful ang environment in contributing to your level of intelligence. If you surround yourself or if you place yourself in an environment that intellectually stimulates you, nakakataas yan ng level of intelligence. Kaya naman, one application of that principle is choosing good schools matter. And what do you mean by good schools? Good schools do their best to provide students the best intellectual environment that they can provide. And I am proud to say na ang Lasal at ang Binild, ito ay mga eskwelahan na talaga namang tinotodo nila yung kanilang effort to provide students with the best intellectual environment there is. A lot of people are saying, mahal sa Lasal, mahal sa Binild. That's very true. But you also have to ask, bakit ba mahal ang Lasal at ang Binild? A big chunk of the tuition fees of students ginagamit ng mga eskwelahan na ito to give students the best intellectual environment in the Philippines. Specifically, saan napupunta yung mga tuition fees na yan? Napupunta yan, for example, sa pag-develop ng mga curriculum, ng mga subjects, which is a part of the environment, di ba? Magaganda dapat yung mga ino-offer na subjects, malinaw na malinaw yung mga learning objectives, malinaw na malinaw yung mga assessment strategies. That's a very good practice in developing curriculum. Oh, napupunta rin yung mga tuition fee ng mga estudyante sa pagbili ng mga top of the line na mga facilities. For example, in both schools, no? Napakaganda ng mga libraries ng mga 'yan. Oh, lahat ng kwarto diyan mga air conditioned, lahat ng kwarto merong LCD projectors, you know? And we have the best books sa mga libraries namin, the most recent books in any fields of knowledge. These schools buy those books brand new, which is again a part of the students' intellectual environment. At syempre pa, kasama na rin dyan yung mga teachers. Diba sabi nga nila, if you want your school to be the best, you need to have the best teachers in the field. And LaSalle and Binil, they have the best teachers in the field. Para yung mga best teachers magturo sa mga eskwelahan na yan, you have to pay them well. And part of the tuition fee that students pay to this school napupunta sa pang salary ng mga top of the line teachers, which is again a part of the child's intellectual environment. So you combine all this, good curriculum, good facilities, good teachers, what do you have? A very top of the line intellectual environment. Kaya mahal sa LaSalle, kaya mahal sa Binild. And having the best intellectual environment for your child, or when you place a person in this kind of intellectual environment, almost 100%, kahit sino pang ilagay mo dyan, paglabas niya ng universidad na yan, that person will be way smarter compared to bago siya pumasok sa mga schools na yan. Kaya nga, one way to really reflect on your intelligence is you ask yourself, do you have an intellectually stimulating environment? Ang pinakamagandang start dyan, yung bedroom mo eh. Yung bedroom mo ba, masasabi mo, honestly, it is intellectually stimulating. When somebody enters your room, paglabas ba niya ng kwarto mo, eh, marami ba siyang mapupulot na katalinuhan? What do you have inside your room? Do you have books? Do you have materials that can increase people's intelligence? Diba? That's one way for you to really reflect on the status of your intelligence. Kung sinasabi mong gusto mong maging matalino, then you can start here. In the first place, are you in an intellectually stimulating environment? There is a third influence on human intelligence, and I call this effort influence. Under pa rin to ng nurture, just like the environment. Ang intelligence kasi, hindi lang siya nadadaan sa genetic influence, hindi lang siya nadadaan sa environment, kinakailangan mo rin mag-effort. The person has to be willing to be intelligent. Diba, logical naman yung statement na yun, kasi pwedeng nasa dugo mo ang pagiging matalino. Pwedeng pinaliligiran mo yung sarili mo ng mga libro. Pero, kung hindi mo naman gagamitin yung iyong pag-iisip, wala ka namang willingness to be intellectually better, then there's no point, there's no chance for you to become smarter. Kinakailangan ginugusto mo rin na maging intelligent. Nag-e-effort ka rin para patalinuhin yung sarili mo. Going back to the case of Marcelo, those words in red, di ba? Marcelo is a hard worker. Diba? Willing siya na maging matalino. Alam niya kasi na wala siyang genetic gift to be smart. Yung kanyang mga parents, medyo hindi maganda ang genetic background. Tapos hindi rin sila ganun kayaman for him to have an intellectually stimulating environment. Pero anong meron siya? Masipag siya. Persistent siya. He is making ways, finding ways on how to make himself more intelligent. And that's what he did. He became a hard worker to nurture his own intelligence. Another good example of this would be our Mayor Isko Moreno in Manila. Diba? Lumaki naman si Isko Moreno nang mahirap siya. Wala siyang intellectually stimulating environment. Pero bakit siya naging matalino? He is so smart that he became the mayor of Manila today. Diba? Anong ginawa niya? Paano niya pinatalino yung sarili niya? Well, dinaan niya sa sipag. dinaan niya sa pag-e-effort niya to improve himself. Ang sabi nga niya in one of his speeches, ang ipinanganak kang mahirap ay hindi kasalanan. Totoo yan. Kapag nanatili kang mahirap, nasa iyo na ang pagkukulang. Totoo rin yan. O, anong ibig sabihin ng pagkukulang? Bakit ka nanatiling mahirap? You did not nurture your skills. You did not nurture your intelligence to improve your status. O, yan naman yung hindi ginawa ni Yorme Isko. Alam niya na kulang na siya sa yaman, kulang na siya sa intellectually stimulating environment. So what did he do? Nagsipag siya. Dinaan niya sa hard work yung pag-improve sa kanyang katalinuhan. Diba, sabi nga ni Brian Herbert, very related to what Yorme Isko was saying, the capacity to learn is a gift, the ability to learn is a skill, and the willingness to learn is a choice. A lot of people, meron naman talaga silang genetic gift to be smart. They are in an intellectually stimulating environment. Pero bakit hindi sila smart? Hindi lumalabas yung tunay na talino nila because they don't make a choice. They are not willing to learn. Diba? Kaya sa tatlo na sinabi ko, ito kasi yung pinaka-kontrolado natin eh. Yung pinaka-willingness natin to make ourselves better in terms of intelligence. So in summary, how do you improve a person's intelligence? There are 3 ways. You find smart genes, you focus on your environment, and of course, most importantly, ito sa tingin ko yung pinaka-kontrolado mo, gustuhin mo na maging matalino. Mag-effort ka na maging matalino. So those are the 3 ways on how you can greatly improve a person's intelligence. If you have any questions, you just ask in the comment section of this video, no? Truth number 2, there are many definitions of intelligence, di ba? For me to elaborate on that, let me start with a case. You are working in a recruitment firm. Your boss gave you a task. You need to find an electrical engineer in a certain post. Aside from credentials, sabi ng boss mo, in-emphasize niya that he wants someone intelligent for that post. You have 3 applicants in front of you. What will be your strategy to spot who is the most intelligent among the 3? So, parang recruitment officer ka dito. Meron 3 nag-a-apply doon sa position na yan. Ang criteria ng boss mo, gusto raw niya matalino. So, ano ang gagawin mo to determine kung sino ang matalino among these 3 applicants in front of you? Okay? Now, the important words are in red para ma-solve natin yung case na ito, the word intelligent. We have to define. How does he define intelligence? Kinakailangan tanungin natin si boss dito. Diba? Sabi niya, gusto niya, yung kukunin mo, matalino. Ang next question mo kay boss, ano ba ang ibig sabihin mo ng matalino? Make sense? Tatanungin mo siya. Paano mo ba masasabi, o boss, ano ba ang pananaw mo sa isang taong matalino? Ano ba yung mga bagay na dapat mong makita sa isang tao for you to say na matalino nga yung taong yun? That's the next question you need to ask your boss. Kasi nga, there are many ways how to define intelligence. Kanina, when we started this video, I said something about this. What is intelligence? Capacity to learn from experience, using metacognitive processes to enhance learning, and the ability to adapt to the surrounding environment. Pero, tandaan nyo, this is only one way to define intelligence. Meron pang ibang kahulugan yung katalinuhan. For example, iba yung sinasabi ni Wexler. Basahin nyo na lang on your own. Iba rin yung sinasabi ni Binet. Iba yung sinasabi ni Terman, 1916. Iba rin naman yung definition ni Pintner about intelligence noong 1921. Again, the point here is intelligence can be defined in different ways. Kaya kung mapapansin ninyo, in psychological testing, maraming klaseng IQ test. Diba pag sinabi mong IQ test, these are tests that measures how smart a person is. Pero bakit maraming pangalan ng IQ test? Bakit hindi na lang tayo magkaroon ng isang universal, general IQ test? After all, we are just measuring a person's intelligence. The answer, kasi nga, different IQ tests will define intelligence in different ways. Iba-iba sila ng definition. Iba-iba sila ng criteria na ginagamit to determine whether someone is intelligent or not. Diba? Kaya nga, if you are working for a company, and then you are administering IQ tests to participants or to the applicants, isa sa mga dapat mong tatanungin regarding the test that you are using is the test I'm using, the way it defines intelligence, does it agree with the way my company defines intelligence? So you just go back to how your company sees intelligence. Kasi different companies will define intelligence in different ways. So kapag gumagamit ka ng IQ test sa recruitment mo, kinakailangan align yung definition nung company mo on intelligence sa definition nung IQ test mo on intelligence. Kaya ngayong ibang companies, they are using their own IQ test. They develop their own to make sure that the way they define intelligence is the same as how the test, the IQ test, is defining intelligence. So, yung mga nagtatrabaho ngayon sa recruitment dyan, if you're listening to this, maybe that's one way that you can work on. You know, magandang tanong yan sa inyong HR. Is the test you are using for recruitment that measures intelligence in line? Is it in line with the way your company is defining intelligence? Other criteria ng mga katalinuhan, marami nga yan, no? Pwedeng SAT, GPA, IQ, gaano ka kabilis mag-isip, gaano ka ka-accurate gumawa ng mga bagay-bagay, how deep you can analyze things, and of course, your ability to create original things. Yun yung tinatawag nating creativity. So, each one of these is a possible criteria for intelligence. Kaya nga, going back doon sa case na in-open up ko sa inyo kanina, dapat, again, tatanungin mo si boss, boss, gusto mo ng matalinong tao sa nakukunin ko, no? Pero ano ba ang definition mo ng matalino? So, pakinggan mo muna, ano ba yung definition ng boss mo sa matalino? And then you decide, based on how he defines intelligence, alin kaya dito yung criteria na sinasabi niya? And make sure the test that you're going to use later on is in line with the criteria that your boss wants from an intelligent person. Pero alam nyo, in relation to this different criteria in of intelligence, merong isang issue na matagal nang pinag-uusapan in cognitive psychology. A lot of psychologists today are saying that the way we define intelligence today, it's very biased to numbers 1 to 4. Masyado tayong academic, masyado tayong traditional in the way we define intelligence. It seems like a lot of people equate intelligence with school performance. And if you notice, numbers 1 to 4, ito yung mga bagay na talagang binibigyang halaga ng eskwelahan, eh. Diba? Kapag ang isang bata, meron siya nung apat na yan, most likely that child will get high grades because they are intelligent. Okay? Kasi most schools define intelligence that way. Very quantitative, very academic. Pero papaano naman yung mga bata na meron silang number 5? Maybe hindi sila ganun kagaling sa numbers 1 to 4, but they are good with number 5. It's unfair to say that they are not intelligent simply because they are not good with numbers 1 to 4. Diba? Hindi porket mababa yung GPA mo, hindi porket hindi mataas yung grade mo, hindi ka Dean's Lister for a specific term, ibig sabihin nun, hindi ka na intelligent. Yun naman yung point na pinag-uusapan ng mga modern cognitive psychologists tulad ni Howard Gardner. Kaya nga si Gardner, sabi niya, we need to expand the definition of intelligence. Hindi porket, hindi natin dapat nililimit lang yung definition of intelligence on what a child can do in school. Because there are other forms of intelligences out there that cannot be measured within the four corners of the classroom. Marami mga tao na hindi naman nag-eskwelahan. Wala naman silang formal training in school, but we can say that they are highly intelligent. Diba? Kaya nga ginawa ni Gardner yung tinatawag niyang multiple intelligences, eh. There are multiple ways on how to measure intelligence. There are multiple expressions of intelligence. Hindi lang yung puro talino sa classroom. And because of this model by Howard Gardner, marami ring mga institutions ngayon, especially in educational institutions, who subscribe to what Gardner was saying about intelligence. Isang halimbawa na nga dyan yung Multiple Intelligence International School. Definitely, this school believes na ang katalinuhan ng bata, hindi lang dapat sinusukat yan sa critical thinking skills that is very academic. Dapat, sinusukat din natin yung ibang, gumagamit din tayo ng ibang tools, ng ibang pamamaraan on how to capture the other forms of intelligences na pwedeng hindi nakikita inside the classroom. Diba? So, merong mga schools na ganyan din ang paniniwala, katulad kay Howard Gardner. And De La Salle College of St. Benilde is a very Gardnerian, applies the Gardnerian principle of intelligence. Naniniwala itong institusyon na ito sa idea ng multiple intelligences. They are all about diversity. They are all about inclusion. Diba? Ibig sabihin ng diverse, iba-iba. Ibig sabihin ng inclusion, isama natin yung lahat ng klase ng intelligence in the way we design our curriculum. In fact, if you're going to analyze the vision of St. Benilde, ang sabi dito, it recognizes the uniqueness of every individual and responds to the diverse needs of all learners. Diverse needs, uniqueness, we are talking about multiple intelligences. Sabi pa nila doon sa kanilang mission, as a learner-centered institution, we recognize diversity by addressing various needs, interests, and cultures. Ibig sabihin, hindi nakakulong yung definition nila ng intelligence on the traditional way of defining intelligence. Kahit anong klase pa yung talino mo, kahit anong klase pa yung talent mo, there is a place for you in this school. So, alam nyo, isang implication na matututunan natin from what Gardner was saying on multiple intelligences is, hindi porket mababa ang grade, hindi matalino. Yung mga nag-a-agree dyan na nanonood sa akin, mag-react kayo doon sa comment section, no? Let me repeat, hindi porket mababa ang grade, eh hindi matalino. Kasi sa kultura natin, ganyan ang thinking natin eh. No? Pag sinabi mong matalino, mataas ang grade. Cum laude, summa cum laude, maraming medals, laging nananalo sa mga quiz B. Pero hindi porket hindi ganon ang bata, di ba? Hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na ang bata hindi matalino. Because intelligences are diverse. Merong mga klaseng mga talino na hindi nakikita sa loob ng classroom. Take for example Steve Jobs and Bill Gates, 'di ba? Traditionally, if you're going to define intelligence in the traditional way, eh mukhang hindi sila papasa kasi in the first place mga out of school naman sila, 'di ba? In the first place, why did they went out of school? Because they don't think that their intelligence is appropriate for the traditional school setting. Nakukulangan sila. Alam nilang matalino sila but in some other ways. Sa tingin nila, yung traditional education, hindi kayang i-handle, hindi kayang ma-enhance yung talino na meron sila. So, they made a decision to drop out of school and enhance and nurture their own intelligence. Hindi porket mababa ang grade, hindi matalino. Truth number 3, as we close, intelligence can be quantified. Ibig sabihin, kaya nating sukatin kung gaano katalino ang isang tao. In fact, meron tayong formula dyan, di ba? Ano ang formula ng IQ? IQ equals mental age divided by chronological age times 100. Times 100. Okay? Ano ang normal IQ? Kapag ganito yung score mo, normal yung intelligence mo, 100. And I want you to analyze, why is the normal IQ 100? It has something to do with the formula. Diba? Kasi, bakit 100 ang normal IQ? That is the time that your mental age is the same as your chronological age. Yung chronological age, ito yung edad mo in terms of your existence. Yung mental age mo, ito yung functioning ng brain mo kung pang ilang taon yung pag-function ng brain mo given your chronological age. So, the way that you can compute for your mental age is to take another test. Merong mga IQ test that can measure your mental age. Pang ilang taon yung pag-function ng iyong pag-iisip. That's your mental age. So, ang pinaka-logical talaga is, kapag 8 years old ka na, that's your chronological age, dapat yung mental age mo pang 8 years old din. Diba? Dahil walang taon ka na sa mundo, dapat yung utak mo ay gumagana siya ng pang 8 years old. So, that would be 8 over 8. You cancel each other times 100. Normal IQ is 100. Diba? Oo. So, ibig sabihin, pag mas tumataas ka ng 100, mas nagiging matalino yung tao. At mas mababa ka sa 100, mas hindi siya nagiging matalino. So that's the way how we compute for intelligence. Again, let me repeat. Why is the normal IQ 100? Because that is the time that mental age is the same as your chronological age, which I think normal people should be like that. You know, kung ano ang edad mo in years, dapat ganun din yung level ng pag-function ng iyong pag-iisip. In fact, in history of psychological testing, we were able to give labels base sa level of intelligence ng tao, di ba? Diyan na natin sinasabi yung mga salitang borderline, low normal, upper normal, bright, gifted, highly gifted, exceptionally gifted, or in some other terms, mga genius, di ba? So yan yung mga labels na nagawa ng mga psychologists in relation to how smart a person is. Now also, don't think that the reason why psychometricians use these labels is to discriminate people. Hindi. The reason why importante yung labels na ito, para malaman natin yung current standing ng mga tao when it comes to intelligence. Because when we know the current standing of people in terms of intelligence, then we can help those people na medyo mababa sa intelligence to improve themselves. Para magkakaroon tayo ng basihan, magkakaroon tayo ng reference points where they are currently at, and then we help them develop techniques para tumaas yung intelligence nila, okay? And later on, we will find out kung gaano kalaki yung improvement nila. Kaya, kinakailangan talaga natin mag-label, you know, ng mga tao when it comes to their intellectual abilities. Okay? So, paano ba natin minemeasure yung intelligence? Again, we use different IQ tests. But different IQ tests, as I've mentioned a while ago, iba-iba sila ng definition of what it means to be smart. Let me just give you some examples of items na ginagamit sa mga IQ test. Oh, halimbawa ganyan. 'Di ba? Tatanungin ka kung ano yung next na drawing na dapat lumabas diyan according to the relationships of the drawings inside the box, 'di ba? Oo. This measures your nonverbal intelligence. We can also measure how good you are in your vocabulary. Kasi yung vocabulary mo, aspeto rin yan ng katalinuhan mo, di ba? For example, in Wechsler, one way to measure how good your vocabulary is, ipapa-define ko sa iyo yung mga words. So, if I am going to administer to you Wechsler, ipapa-define ko sa iyo in your own words anong ibig sabihin ng salitang terminate, anong ibig sabihin ng salitang confide, ano ang ibig sabihin ng salitang usurp. Diba? So, yan yung pamamaraan ng ways in measuring intelligence. Ways can also measure how good you are in understanding questions. Gaano ka kagaling sumagot ng mga tanong? How do we test that? I will ask you questions and I will score the way you answer my questions. So, tatanungin kita, why do people need to wear watches? Tapos, sasagutin mo. O, after mo sagutin, i-scoran ko yung lalim ng sagot mo. Okay? Why most of the foods need to be cooked? How is a boat and automobile similar with each other? Again, how sophisticated your answer is will determine your score in answering these questions. So, yung overall score na makukuha mo dito will be your comprehension score according to the system of Wechsler. So, ang bottom line lang dito, again, intelligence is something that we can objectively measure. Hindi yan nadadaan sa tantsahan lang, hindi yan nadadaan sa chismis-chismisan lang, kasi we have a tendency to do that, no? Yung to base people's intelligence on their looks, to base intelligence on whether we like people or not, di ba? Hindi mga tamang paraan yan in assigning how intelligent a person is. There is an objective way. Merong eksaktong pamamaraan. Pwede nating sukatin kung gaano katalino ang isang tao through the use of the different IQ test. Pero isang pag-iingat lang sa paggamit ng mga IQ test, no? Please, IQ test don't entirely define human capacity. Kasi in our education system today, meron tayong thinking na we don't look at students in a positive light when we learn they have low IQ scores. Diba? Parang ginajudge na kaagad natin yung kakayanan ng mga tao based on the IQ score na nakuha nila. Sabi nga dun sa second bullet, no, it is wrong to judge person's future based on IQ test. test. In the first place, yung pag-measure ng intelligence via IQ test, eh, isang paraan lang yan to measure intelligence. Merong mga klase ng intelligences na hindi mo kayang sukatin gamit ang IQ test. What if a student is smart in other ways, in a different way, other than answering IQ test well? Unfair naman kung sasabihan mo na yung estudyanteng yung hindi smart simply because mababa yung IQ test niya. Pwedeng matalino siya sa ibang bagay, hindi lang talaga siya magaling sa IQ test, 'di ba? Remember, there are many different expressions of intelligence. Pero yun na nga eh, yung traditional education thinking natin, we equate a person's future on IQ scores. We have that parang mental shortcut na kapag mababa ang IQ score, walang future. Mataas ang IQ score, bright ang future. It's not the case, di ba? Tinan nyo yung nangyari kay Bill Gates. I failed in some subjects in exam, which is an indication na siguro mababa yung kanyang IQ score, no? But my friend passed in all. Yung friend niya mataas ang IQ scores. Now he is an engineer on Microsoft, but Bill Gates, I am the owner of Microsoft. Mas matalino pa rin si Bill Gates. It's just that again, iba kasi yung talino ni Bill Gates kumpara doon sa friend niya na pinapasa yung lahat ng exam. So IQ scores, IQ test, you cannot just use that as basis for a person's future or for a person's intelligence. Kinakailangan kung talagang seryoso ka sa pag-assess ng intelligence ng tao, you really need to consider other criteria. Dapat marami kang mga available tools para ma-capture mo kung ano ba talaga yung appropriate test na dapat mong gamitin for a person para ma-measure mo yung kanyang intelligence. Alright? So anyway, as we end, ano ba yung mga takeaways natin for our lesson for today on intelligence? Number one, I hope I convince you that intelligence is a very important asset. Talagang marami magandang nangyayari sa buhay natin when we work on our intelligence. Kapag mataas ang level of intelligence mo, you can solve a lot of problems, you can answer many questions, itaga mo na sa bato, your life will improve. It is an asset. Therefore, ano ang dapat na response natin? We need to prioritize improving our intelligence. At alam nyo, no, sa Bible, kung babasahin mo yung pages of the Bible is very serious in encouraging its readers to improve on their intelligence. Sa lengguwahe ng Biblia, ang intelligence, ang tawag niya dyan, wisdom eh. In Proverbs 4:7, anong sabi? Acquire wisdom, and with all that you acquire, acquire understanding. Patalinuhin mo ang sarili mo. Ephesians 1:17, I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know Him better. We need to be smart. The Bible wants us to be smart because the Bible knows that this will improve our life. In fact, yung isang model in the Bible na talagang mahalaga ang intelligence is none other than King Solomon. Diba? For those of you who are not familiar with King Solomon, anak siya ni King David. Nung nawala si David, si Solomon na ang magiging hari ng mga Israelites. And then one night, God talked to him through his dream. And God was asking Solomon kung ano yung gusto niyang hingin. Ibibigay lahat ng Diyos yung hihilingin ni Solomon in that dream. Diba? So anong hiningin ni Solomon when God asked him what does he want? Ang sabi sa 1 Kings 3:9, so give your servant a discerning heart to govern your people and to distinguish between right and wrong. For who is able to govern this great people of yours? In other words, King Solomon was asking for intelligence. Humingi siya ng katalinuhan mula sa Diyos. And take note kung ano ang naging response ng Diyos after King Solomon asked for intelligence, very positive. Which tells us that God wants us to improve our intelligence. Sabi nga sa 1 Kings 3:10-14, the Lord was pleased that Solomon has asked for this. So God said to him, since you have asked for this and not for long life or wealth for yourself, nor have asked for the death of your enemies but for discernment in administering justice, ano ang gagawin? I will do what you have asked. Bibigyan talaga siya ng katalinuhan. I will make you wise and discerning heart so that there will never have been anyone like you, nor will there ever be. That's how God wants us to really prioritize intelligence in our life. In fact, kung itutuloy mo pa yung pagbabasa sa verse 13 and 14, kahit hindi hilingi ni Solomon, binigay din ni God sa kanya. Simply because Solomon asked for what is important, for something that God wants us to work on, and that is intelligence. So, kailangan talaga isa yan sa mga values na pinagahalagahan natin every day of our life. When we wake up in the morning, isa sa mga mission natin sa buhay is to improve our intelligence. Na sana, at the end of the day, we became smarter than we were the previous day. Number two, clarify what intelligence you want or what intelligence you need. This time, I'm talking to people working in the recruitment or in the placement field. No? Diba nga, nagbibigay kayo ng mga IQ test doon sa mga applicants. Key question, yung hinahanap ba ng test mo, tugma ba yan sa definition ng intelligence ng kumpanya mo? That's very important. You need to clarify what intelligence do you really want from these applicants. And make sure na yung test na ginagamit mo, the way it measures intelligence is in line with how the company that you are working for is defining intelligence. Dapat tugma yan. Kasi magiging unfair eh. No? Yung company mo rin yung magsasuffer kapag hindi tugma. Sabi ng kumpanya mo, gusto namin yung mga kukunin mong mga aplikante magagaling sa problem solving. Pero yung test na ginagamit mo, isang test na nagme-measure ng creativity. Diba? So, hindi siya tugma. So, ang mangyayari niyan, kapag may mga pinapadala kang mga tao, meron kang mga pinapapasok na aplikante in your company, ang tendency niyan, hindi sila magiging tugma doon sa hinahanap ng company. They will not be fit with what the company is looking for. So, you really need to work on number two. And number three, which is in a way related to number two, no? Dahil maraming klase nga ng intelligence, we need to respect and value other intelligences. Itigil na natin yung close-minded definition of intelligence that it's all about grades. It's all about school performance. Ilan ba ang medal mo? Ilan ba yung nasalihan mong quiz B? Valedictorian ka ba? Salutatorian ka ba? Cum laude ka ba? Summa cum laude ka ba? I mean, don't get me wrong. These people who are cum laude and summa cum laude, are they smart? Yes, they are smart. But that is not the only way to be smart. Pwedeng hindi ka cum laude, pwedeng hindi ka summa cum laude, yet you are still smart. It's just that you have a different form of intelligence na hindi kayang masukat ng traditional education. We really need to take this seriously, lalong-lalo na sa mga teachers, di ba? Huwag natin i-judge yung katalinuhan ng isang estudyante based on quizzes, based on long exams, based on recitation. Kasi to tell you, marami mga estudyante, hindi ganun kataas ang exam, hindi ganun kataas ang quizzes, hindi man sila nagtataas ng kamay to answer your questions, but they can be considered very intelligent. It's just that yung kanilang intelligence, iba ang expression eh. Hindi nila ine-express yon sa loob ng classroom. Remember what Einstein said about this. Sabi niya, everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid. Unfortunately, many students today, they feel stupid. Why? Because teachers judge them to be stupid. But what is the basis of these teachers to say that these students are not intelligent? Traditional tools, quizzes, exam, recitation, magaling ka ba sa critical thinking? Again, don't get me wrong. Yung mga criteria na yan can be intelligence, but these are not the only criteria. Unfair naman sa mga estudyante na iba ang kanilang intelligence, and yet we judge their intelligence using a wrong tool. Yun yung sinasabi ni Einstein na judging a fish by its ability to climb a tree. Diba? Kung ang isang estudyante meron siyang fish ability, kinakailangan yung test na ibibigay mo sa kanya, yung mga exercises na ibibigay mo sa kanya, pang-isda. Diba? dapat tugma yung klase ng intelligence nung bata doon sa curriculum na meron siya. So that's a very, very important principle to be applied, especially in the field of education. So yung mga nakikinig ngayon na nagtatrabaho in the educational field, please remember that principle. There must be a match between what we teach our students, how we assess our students, with what kind of intelligences are they excelling in. And number four, we can choose to improve our intelligence. Ito yung pinakamagandang takeaway, di ba? Pinag-usapan na natin yung definition ng intelligence. Pinag-usapan natin na nasusukat ang intelligence. Halimbawa, sinukat mo yung intelligence mo. Kung paano mo man sinukat yan, using what definition, no? Nakita mo mababa ka sa intelligence. Is there a way to improve your intelligence? The answer is yes. There are many ways on how to improve one's intelligence. Hindi porket mababa ang intelligence mo, until the day you die, mababa intelligence mo. The key here is to stimulate your thinking, stimulate your mind. The more you stimulate your mind, the more you use your mind, the more you challenge your mind, mas tumataas yung level of intelligence mo. At ano yung mga paraan na pwede natin gamitin to stimulate the mind? Dito nakalagay sa slide. Expose yourself to different ideas sa pamamagitan ng pagbabasa. Let me emphasize pagbabasa. Studies after studies are showing that reading books is a very good way, a powerful way on improving intelligence. Bad news, pakonti na pakonti ang mga kabataan ngayon na mahilig magbasa. In fact, there was this one survey in the United States. More than 50% of people in the United States, they no longer read for pleasure. They only read when they are asked to read. Not a good attitude. Sana hindi nangyayari sa Pilipinas yan, no? Pero based on my observation, because of social media, because of Netflix, very few kids today value reading. Most kids today would rather watch than read. They would rather be entertained than learn. Kinakailangan baguhin natin to if we want to improve the level of intelligence. Another way to stimulate your mind is to discover things, explore on things, continually become curious, and of course, yung last point, wag natin kakalimutan, no? You can also learn from other people. Improving intelligence is also a social thing. Hindi lang, ang intelligence, hindi lang laging ikaw yan nagtatrabaho. You can also ask help from other people to help you improve your intelligence. Diba? Increasing your intelligence is also a social activity. Sabi nga ng Proverbs, diba? Listen to advice and accept instruction that you may gain wisdom in the future. In other words, one way to make yourself smarter is to listen to advice and accept instruction coming from people who are more intelligent than you. Kaya dapat kapag may nakikita kang mga taong mas matalino sa'yo, huwag kang ma-intimidate. Huwag kang manliit. Rather, use that opportunity, okay, to improve your intelligence. Anong tawag nila doon sa English? Pick up their brains. Diba? The more you pick up the brains of people smarter than you, the more you are making yourself more intelligent. Sabi nga ni Brian Herbert, again, sinabi ko na kanina to, no? The capacity to learn is a gift. The ability to learn is a skill. But the willingness to learn is a choice. And if you want to really improve that important asset called intelligence, anong kailangan mong gawin? Meron kang willingness to learn. Meron kang choice na gagawin. Every day, you choose to make yourself smarter than you were yesterday. Thank you for listening and God bless.